Good morning, Stephen Whiteside here with your daily market outlook for Thursday, June 7th, 2012. In the pre-market this morning, we've got futures up across the board, so we're looking at a continuation of Wednesday's positive trading activity. Now, Wednesday was a positive day for the market and certainly changed a lot of the charts. We've got a lot of buy signals to deal with this morning. Could I say anything negative right now about yesterday's trading activity? There's a lot of obvious things you could say, but sometimes you just have to hold your nose and go with it. We didn't see that much money go back into financial services, which is a concern, and we really didn't break out above any major resistance yesterday. So we've got lots of buy signals. We have to take them. There's a pretty good chance we put in a low for the markets last Friday, with the U.S. markets making lows on Friday, and so we're looking for that reversal to hold, and we're looking for higher prices here. Taking a look at our pieces of the puzzle, the TSX moved up to last week's high yesterday. The VIX, we're still waiting for it to break down, so fear dissipated, but the trend for fear has not started to move down just yet. That's a little different in the U.S. We're right on the edge of a new buy signal for the S&P 500, while the VIX generated a sell signal, and we're on a new buy signal for the NASDAQ 100, and the VIX for the NASDAQ 100 generated a sell signal. So fear is starting to dissipate. The global Dow moved up yesterday to the upper channel line. Not a buy signal yet, but that could change on Thursday with the Asian markets being positive and the European markets being positive today. The bonds were down sharply. They're still on a buy signal, but a nice sharp move from last week. You can see they peaked on Friday and have been starting to break down here. Similar situation for the U.S. dollar. Nice down day yesterday. Still technically on a buy signal, but we want to see money come out of bonds. We want to see money come out of the U.S. dollar, and we'd be having a totally different conversation if neither of those things happened yesterday. Money's flowing back into the euro, so people are willing to take on risk. You can see that in the Canadian dollar and especially in the Australian dollar. So people are a little more willing to take on risk, and that's what we want. When people want to take on risk, they want to buy stocks. You're seeing money flow back into the energy sector. No change in trend for Brent crude, for light crude, for gasoline, for heating oil, or for natural gas, but money was flowing in yesterday. Little up move for copper yesterday. Nice continuation to the upside for gold. We moved from the 50 to the 100 and the 200-day moving averages yesterday. And gold is down a little in the pre-market this morning, but no major change there. Silver popped yesterday. The pros are back in control, so that's a good sign. Next up, let's take a look at our leveraged ETFs. We've got a bunch of orders to place this morning. Unfortunately, the fun that we had in May has now officially come to an end. You've had lots of chances to take money off the table and lock in some profits. So, and some of you have, I know, have totally liquidated. And we're just sitting in cash waiting for the next trade to set up. And so here we are. We're officially out of our bear for the S&P 500. We're now back in the bull for the S&P 500. We're officially out of the NASDAQ 100 bear. We're back in the bull. We're now out of the TSX 60. Remember last week we waved off this trade. And unfortunately we just did a round trip up. And that's very important. We've now put in a double top in the bear, and so that's a bullish signal for the overall market. And so we came down and we got down to last week's low and looking to break through that this week and looking to break out above last week's high. And I think we'll be able to do it today. So we're looking at the TSX 60 bull. We have a buy signal there. We have a sell signal in the energy bear. We have a buy signal in the energy bull. Nothing going on yet in financial services. Hopefully they'll follow today and we'll get a sell signal in the bear and a buy signal in the bull. But we don't have that yet. No change for the gold bull ETF. We do have a bearish reversal signal. We were able to push through resistance. You know, we've got the mathematical line here, but that line was support. We gapped lower, came back up, tried to fill that open gap. Once that was done, the market moved two lines down. Now we've moved two lines up. We tried to move ahead and reversed, and so we'll have to see if we get fall through to the downside today to confirm that bearish reversal signal to see if that is a top for this particular move. I don't think it will be, but we'll just have to wait and see what the market does on Thursday. Looking at the crude oil bear, no change there, and no change in the natural gas bear. Last up this morning, quick look at the 60-minute charts. We've got the VIX down below the flypaper channel, which of course I look at as being bullish. Haven't been able to take out the recent area of support, which we've been looking at. And the TSX came right up to the line we drew across the screen yesterday. We talked about what could happen yesterday morning. We had that gap, and then we had this gap over here, in which this particular thrust up filled that open gap, and so then again that's where we ran up to yesterday. So of course we're looking for the TSX to take out yesterday's high on Thursday. We're looking for energy stocks to continue to move up. They're above the flypaper channel on the hourly charts. That gives us a buy signal on the daily charts. Financial services ran up to the flypaper channel yesterday. We're looking to see if we can break out above that. And we're looking to see if we can keep gold stocks above the flypaper channel on Thursday. We might open lower this morning, but I don't think we're going to be able to break down through the flypaper channel on Thursday. Okay, that's all for Thursday morning, folks. We have got some orders to place this morning, and we're finally locking in all the profits from the May run-up in the bear ETFs, and we're going to buy some bull ETFs for the month of June. Have a great day, and I'll talk to you again next on Friday morning.